Happy day, my dear little children. I hope you are all good. Welcome to English class. Today lesson 5, Scratching the Tiger's Back. It's a poem. Children, before move to the poem, we have to know about the author. Scratching the Tiger's Back, which is written by K.K.N. Darwan, 1937. He is a poet and short story writer who was born in Lahore, now in Pakistan. His poems have a winsome appeal and sensitivity. One characteristic feature of his poetry is a concern for nature. His collection of poems, The Keeper of the Dead, received the Sahitya Academy Award in 1984. Now, we move to the poem, Scratching the Tiger's Back. Regrettably, the tiger is known for fiery attack, but there are days when the tiger says, "Come here and scratch my back." His moods vary with meals. At times, the tiger is not charged with electricity. His blood isn't that hot. He feels so lazy that he lazies. Stays put, doesn't go places. Its stripes doesn't blaze. His skin doesn't glow. He feels so lazy that time and the afternoon and the winter sun turn slow. First answer's explanation. It's rather sad or unfortunate that the tiger is known only as a ferocious animal that attacks and kills. However, there are times when even a tiger wants to lazy around and have someone scratch his back. His mood often depends upon whether he has had his meal. When he's hungry, he is active and has the energy to go out in the forest and hunt for his prey. But there are times when he has already eaten, his stomach is full and he is not eager to attack. At this time, he is so sacrificed with his meal that he feels tired after a hunt and lazier, retired to his den and doesn't want to go anywhere. His entire body gives an impression of being tired and doesn't have the otherwise fiery look that characters his body. The dullness of his skin and scraps convey his reluctance to do anything except relax. He behaves in a relaxed and lazy manner at such time. The afternoon of the winter days seems much longer than it actually is, and time seems to run slower than it usually does. Second stanza. At autumn evening, when for a moment brief light through the leaves, is itself black and gold, black shadow and gold leaf. That evening as the sun sinks, it will not think of him with fear. And even if you do, the tiger will be on the far bank, not here. That night you will not dream of tiger as a print of black daggers and gold daggers. Second stanza's explanation. On autumn evening, there is a moment when the rays of setting sun fall on the leaves, and these reflect the golden color of the sunlight. This makes the tiger look brighter and they look golden, but they also cast a shadow which is black. Seen in this black and gold shadow, the tiger doesn't look frightening. Even if the fear still lingers, there will be nothing to worry about since the tiger will be on the opposite side of the river and not close to you. You will not be affected by the sight of the tiger and you will not have nightmare in which the tiger will appear as a print of black and gold triangles. Now, third stanza. And even if he does enter your dreams, he will do so softly. He will not chant, he will not bark into your sleep. All he will tell you is, I am well because I lunched well. I too, I am made by God. I am a sample. I am like you. Both good and evil dwell in me too. For good, gold. For evil, black. Tonight, I will say nothing. You can scratch my back. Now, third stanza's explanation. If out of fear you still dream of him, he will not be charging in these dreams. He will not be trying to kill anyone. He will enter your dreams softly without rousing, and he will not disturb your peaceful sleep. All he will say is that he is fine because he has had a good meal in the afternoon, and so he is not looking for more meat. He will explain that he is just another creature created by God like all of us, just as everyone has both bad and good qualities in them. The tiger is also a combination of both good and evil, despite by his gold and black stripes. He assures us that tonight he will not harm anyone. With this assurance, he announces that we can scratch his back in order to make him feel good. I hope you understood this poem. Thank you, children.